Is the camera on right now? Alright, can I have some more vodka? Alright, so I assume it is. So, Privyets everybody. Alexander II was the Tsar of Russia and he was born in Moscow. His education was done in a military sense and he himself was a boy of average intelligence.
He had to relocate due to technical difficulties. Alexander's tutor was Swedish and his name was Vasily Zhukovsky. Alexander's tutor taught him French, Latin, German, and he was also tutored in mathematics and he received a very excellent education. But his tutor was quite harsh.
This is Russia, okay? Okay. Sorry. This is Russia, okay? Okay. In Russia, we do things a little differently. Industry is no, okay? You get it? Okay. That's how we do things. Listen. Alexander, eat the potato. Makes you strong, like bear. We also make vodka. It's very good, but you can't have me, okay?
His father oversaw his education, and he was a very abusive and repressive man. His name was Nicholas I.
What are you doing, Alexander? Get inside and study military tactics. What are you doing? Gosh.
Okay, so. This is your future. Okay, you understand? Okay? No. This future, okay? Okay? Pow, okay?
In March 13th of 1855, Alexander II became Tsar at the age of 37.
Ah, welcome. Welcome to your graduation. You may pick your weapon.
This is good. You could get used to this. But there is something missing.
Get this out of my way, Nikolai.
This is much better.
Throughout his life, Alexander was tempted to be assassinated because of his autocratic nature, which Dmitri felt was too great. He listed his intentions in a letter he wrote.
I should probably write to my wife.
I have long been tormented by the thought and given no rest by my doubts why my beloved simple Russian people has to suffer so much. Why next to the eternal simple peasant and laborer in his factory and workshop are there people who do nothing? Idle nobles, a horde of officials, and other wealthy people, all living in shining houses. The man really responsible is the Tsar. The Tsar is the first of the nobles. He never holds out his hand to the people because he is himself the people's worst enemy.
Throughout his life, Alexander was tempted to be assassinated multiple times. The first one was in 1866, in which a young man named Dmitri attempted to shoot Alexander but was restrained by one of his guards. In 1873, Alexander II was attempted to be assassinated for the second time, and this was done so by socialist ideologues who felt that Alexander II was too autocratic. They planted bombs in his chambers, but he didn't even feel the bombs because the bombs exploded too far beneath him. So this attempt was quite unsuccessful.
What was that? Why someone attack my potatoes?
In 1880, Alexander II was attempted to be assassinated for the third time. Bombs were planted underneath the streets in which he walked every single day. This was failed because the bombs cannot be set off.
Come get your cheese! We got Kobe Jack, Monterey Jack, shredded cheese. Get your all kinds of cheeses here!
It's not working!
Why are these cheese prices so low?
I'm gonna have to check the supply under the request of Alexander II. Oh no!
Oh no!
In March of 1881, Alexander II and his wife were killed by a bomb in the streets of St. Petersburg.
Alexander and his wife are gonna be riding down their carriage in St. Petersburg, down the street, okay?
Okay, remember, we're doing this for the people's will.
Okay, wait, shh. There's a little hair in your face.
Are you ready?
Yes,
let's go.
Hello, Russia! Hello! Hello, St. Petersburg! Hey, are you ready for dinner tonight?
Yeah.
Very good.
Alexander and his wife Maria were buried together in St. Peter and Paul Fortress, St. Petersburg.